Nepal is honestly one of the most beautiful countries in the world. White man cannot do a very good job. Now, 40 years ago, the villagers used to beat him. It's important, whatever you want to do in your life, your dreams, your desires.
Namaste, bhai. Namaste. TikTok?
On my channel, we go to mosques, we go to Hindu temples, we go to Buddhist temples, we go to churches. Now, I don't want you to think that I'm trying to push a religion on you. That's not it. Hey guys, my name is Jack Tor, and welcome to my YouTube channel. G'day and good morning, guys. If you've ever wondered what a day in the life of a rural village in Nepal, what a rural villager does in their daily life, well, come along with me today as I'm going to be with Meg, my friend, who is from this village, and we're going to be experiencing a day in the life in a rural village. So this morning, I woke up, I took a shower, I brushed my teeth, I watched my new Nepali brother get his tooth taken out, and I also ate breakfast. Now this morning what we're doing today is we're going into town, down in the valley here, interacting with locals and just enjoying our day. After that we'll come back here to the village, we'll explore some other little places of the village, see animals, maybe do some work, talk to some people, and just have a fun day. So yeah, come along with me today, be right beside me today. And let's have a good day. Let's see what we see today. I'm with Meg.
Hi,
Meg's dressed up all nicely. I don't really own any nice clothes because I'm traveling. But I hope my toppy is enough. I do have a white shirt in my bag that I'll put on when we get to church. I just didn't want to put it on now in case it gets dirty because it's a white shirt. But yeah, let's go. Can I tell you what's been on my mind? Sick and tired of the 9 to 5 in the city life. Hey, darling, we could get out of town. See the beautiful world around, wanna see it now. Pack our bags and get in that car. So these steps here that we're now walking on that you can see, Meg and the people in his village actually built all of this. Now the best part about this though is the Nepali government paid each worker 1,000 rupees per day to build this, which is amazing. So Meg's grandma applied for this and the Nepali government pays the workers to build this, and that puts in infrastructure for this area because the government workers can't get to this area because it's very far, so the local people have to do it, and you send photos in as proof and the workers, how many workers there are and how long it takes, and yeah, and then they pay. So it was really good for Meg because Meg was visiting his village at the time and he got to do some work and work with his family. These steps, all these new steps lead to Meg's house, so that's a bonus as well. Meg and I are walking an hour today. Now, in this whole area, people are Christian or Hindu. So yeah, it's really interesting. There's a lot of Christians here, hence why there's 5 churches. So it'll be new for anyone who's watching from Nepal, who if you're Hindu, then this will be a new experience for you. to see what a church is like in rural Nepal. I probably won't film too much just to be respectful, but I say you'll see a little bit and feel the vibe. Then after that, we'll be doing some other things. When people do commit suicide, they hang themselves in the trees. And I said to Meg, what would be the reasons why they commit suicide? One would be lack of money, lack of opportunity, not being able to provide for their kids, obviously depression, anxiety, not happy with their life. This guy, this house here, this guy committed suicide about 3 years ago. So would you say maybe one person a year or? Okay, wow, so about one person a year commits suicide, which is really sad, especially because the population in this area is very low. So that's quite, you know, that's a lot. That's why I've also came out here, to raise awareness for this area, provide more tourism, more job opportunities. If you're a government worker, please look into this area. If there's anything that you can do to provide more aid or more opportunity into this area, then please do so. Lots of places in Nepal need it, but it'd be great if you could look into this area as well. Just so stunning here. Just some of these views just blow me away. Just look at this. So natural beauty. You know, man-made things can never outdo natural beauty like this, can they? Here is one of my most favorite parts of this trail. There's butterflies, birds chirping. Feels like the Garden of Eden. There's crops being planted, this wonderful stone pebble pathway. It's just stunning. The freshest air. You could get high off this, let me tell you. High on life. Ew. We're now over the river on the other side, and this is where Meg's house is, and we just walked all the way down that massive hill. I can't believe I just did that, but the news is we gotta walk back up. Crazy. About 5 minutes away now, and then yeah, it should be interesting. And then this afternoon we've got a few things planned as well. But yeah, stick around. Okay, so the church is just up here on the hill. Now I've changed into a white shirt to look a bit fresh. My topi is off because in church you can't wear hats. So yeah, should be good. Let's see.
We should fix it inside, bro.
Yeah, okay.
Hell yeah. We should fix it first.
Hello. Hello. Hello.
So right now, Meg and I and Boyne here are the first ones in the church.
So we're just opening up all of the windows and doors because the power is actually out for the whole entire area. There was a massive storm last night and all the power was off. We thought that the church would still have power, so we brought our power banks to charge, but they don't, unfortunately, but that's okay. So this roof looks very new as well. So they've done some renovations here. Also, one thing that I want to mention here is on my channel, we go to mosques, we go to Hindu temples, we go to Buddhist temples, we go to churches. Now, I don't want you to think that I'm trying to push a religion on you. That's not it. Just enjoy this different experience, just like when you see Buddhist temples or Hindu temples or mosques. So yeah, I always say that about any religion we go to. I don't want this to be a political view or a religious view. Just enjoy the difference about religion. I think religion is great. Any religion is great for people to have. It gives a importance in life, and if people believe that religion to be true in their heart and in their soul and in their mind, then that's a great thing. And if you don't believe, then that's also fine. Everyone's on a journey and that's perfectly okay. Okay, so we're now going inside the church. Job, I travel around the world to many countries, many religions, and there's a lot of different things that I've seen. And focusing on the different religions part, sometimes when I'm traveling, it's very hard for me. I miss my family at home, I miss my friends. So it's important, whatever you want to do in your life, your dreams, your desires. Okay, so right now we're leaving the church. The locals were absolutely amazed by the drone. They've never seen anything like that, and never seen anything like me, actually. Anyway, so we've been invited now into the pastor's home to drink some tea, maybe have a little bit of food. So people here are so welcoming. So let's go. Lovely home. Okay, thank you. Dhanyavad. Wow. Oh, look at his view. Wow, nice view of the mountain. Lovely.
Very good.
Very good.
Yes, everything is captured.
Yeah, wow. This is so cool. Dhanyavad.
Dhanyavad.
Okay, thank you.
Nirmar.
Nikma.
Oh.
Okay.
Okay, so right now we're all in the pastor's house. We're about to drink some tea. Everyone from the church has come, so this is really, really cool.
So the question is, they both look so young for their age. What's the secret? What are they eating? Are they exercising? What's their advice to everyone else?
They are local and they was born here.
Yep.
They was live here and they eat like local foods.
Yeah.
There is no artificial and everything is local, like environmentally, this is so good. That's why I think.
Bye.
Well, so we just left the pastor's home then. I was so surprised. Everyone from the church seemed like turned up, and I got a chance to speak to the pastor and ask him some questions. So when they first started this church, there was only 9 members. And it was in his house. They used to meet every Sunday in his house. And for 3 years,
he was banned from the village. No one talked to him at all. The only people that talked to him was the 9 members in the church. Now, 40 years ago, the villagers used to beat him for being Christian. That's crazy. And really, really sad. It's really good that people have came to times now of accepting other people's religion, but that's crazy to hear that he was beaten for preaching his religion. Another thing that surprised me is one of the elders. He actually had a dream of a foreigner flying some type of helicopter or something, and he wasn't too sure like what it meant or anything like that, and here I am today flying my drone. So yeah, you do with that as you will. That's what he said. So that's crazy, isn't it? So I hope you enjoyed the experience of what a church is like in rural Nepal. So what Meg and I are going to do now is we're going to go and get some lunch in the town, and then yeah, we'll hike back up and I'll show you guys some other things that we've got planned today. So just before we eat, we're actually walking into the local school here. This is where Meg's brother studies. And yeah, it's now Saturday, so there's no one here. This is actually where your brother's studying this year, class 10. This is where Meg's brother will study. And then right now they've just got some workers building some classrooms and stuff. So yeah, this is really cool. So there's 1, 2, 3 buildings, which is really good for a small community like this. Okay, so we're just going to go and grab some lunch now, which is good because Meg and I are a little bit hungry, aren't we?
And I need to buy something here.
Oh, okay. Okay, so we got to buy something as well. So what are we eating, Meg? It's called chow chow?
Oh, yeah.
Chow chow.
Fried eggs.
Fried chow chow with eggs. Okay, cool. I'm excited to try that. I've never had chow chow before, so let's see how we go. Okay, so Didi here, she's just making the chow chow. Wow. Mito?
Mito sauce.
Oh, okay. Looks very good. So I believe it's noodles, fried egg, and some other things as well. Yeah, this is her kitchen. Has all the different ingredients. They don't have much to offer because I think there's some supplies coming in, so that's why we're having noodles and eggs and not meat or vegetables or anything. Very interesting. This is what a Nepali kitchen looks like.
You say? You found the story.
Bye bye.
Thank you. All tucked away.
So just behind me, they're unloading a tractor full of supplies. So the tractor comes up from the town and gives all the supplies here to this shop. Meg's just buying some eggs at the moment for our dinner tonight. But yeah, as you can see, things like Mountain Dew here, rice, and other goods and necessities they bring up here with a tractor. So yeah, that's really interesting, isn't it? That's how they bring their supplies up to the village, and then way up to where we're hiking is brought by human transportation. It's not just your standard truck like you get in Australia and you go to Woolworths and pick up some food. It's not that easy.
Hello, banana.
Hello.
You scared?
Yeah.
Most of the kids I talk to in the village, they're so scared. One, because of the camera, and two, they don't normally see people who look like me, so. But he's so cute. Okay, let's go.
I can't let you go, baby. I just wanna tell you that.
So the locals here are just collecting wood for winter and for cooking and stuff, but you can see here the little boy is even helping as well. Helping mom, not complaining, not crying, not asking for an iPad or an iPhone. Let me watch cartoons.
Hello. Hello. Wow, hello.
Okay, so we're going to go and visit this man's buffalo right here. We've just asked if we can come and say hello.
Wow. Very furry. Hello. Wow. Hello.
Wow, they're massive animals, aren't they? Wow. I love the horns. Big horns. And this one here is a baby?
I think. Yeah.
Buffaloes here live up to about 30 years. This man, he'll raise the buffaloes until they're fat enough to eat. He'll have that for meat, and then they can store the meat and they'll eat that for a long time. So they don't really sell the buffaloes, not that often. So yeah, really interesting. This guy's loving a head scratch right here. All of my friends say, take care. So the afternoon sun's coming down now. As you can see here, this village, it's so beautiful. So beautiful. I love walking through this bit every time. I think this is only the third time I've walked through here. But wow, is it so beautiful. If most of the workers come out and work after lunch and early morning. During when it's very hot, most people just sit inside and rest. It's a shame that we're not here when the corn has been fully grown and they're harvesting that, because that would be a really cool sight to see. So most of the farm work that's being done now is like weeding the corn, collecting wood, chopping wood, looking after goats, looking after buffaloes. What else? Like working on the house. So yeah, there's not much planting or picking the crops yet in this season. Okay, so we were just walking back a different way, actually. Meg was taking me a different way. But we've just went past his auntie's house, and she's just invited us in.
Everybody invited us in.
Everyone seems to know Meg, or is Meg's family. We get invited to every place. It's so cool. So yeah, let's go have a look. Wow, this is a lovely home. Wow. Wow. Okay, so we're just trying some chia now. Mmm, really good, very hot. Nice and sweet though, really nice. Awesome biscuits as well, wow. The hospitality here is so good. So this cat just came in here to eat some noodles, some chow chow. Cat loves it so much. Okay, so we just left Meg's grandma's house and we're walking down here. Look at all this water running down the road and then down here. This is crazy. Such a cool sight to see. And then over here, there's a massive rock. I just love this country. There's so much random things. So much going on. So my senses. It's so beautiful. Nepal is honestly one of the most beautiful countries in the world, without a doubt.
Okay, yeah, listen, I try mune.
Uncle!
Why na? Ah, uksing try ukuru ne uksoti.
Okay, so I've always wanted to do this, guys. You see people walking around with this. It looks very heavy and very hard. I will probably fail, but let's see. Oh, shit. Okay. Wow. This is not easy. I can see why they put it on their head though, because you could walk long distances with heavy things, but this is not easy, guys. Wow, that's crazy.
Wow.
Okay, all right, I'm gonna put this down now.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, Zach, how was your experience?
New. New. So, pick up the sticks. Okay. Okay. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is how it's done properly. Bye-bye. This white man cannot do a very good job. Oh man, oh man. Look how she just crossed the river there, like it was nothing. So easy.
I heard from a friend of mine who saw you just the other day.
So Meg's found another friend or family member. He knows everyone here.
Since
you were back in town, it's been a long time since you've been around. Remember when we used to make the streets unsafe together, baby? We were young and foolish then. Oh, how I wish we could go back.
So sometimes when I walk through here, Feels like I'm walking through a Hobbit movie, like the Hobbit set in Lord of the Rings. It's just so picturesque. Yeah, it just gives off that vibe, you know? I love it. I expect like some Hobbit to jump out and be like, hey guys.
I'm a Hobbit.
All the little kids playing. Hello.
They're all shy.
Hello. Hey.
Right now we're about to cross this bridge just here. Now this bridge was built only 3 months ago and built by Meg's dad, his uncle, and Meg's brother. Now this was paid by the Nepali government, and Meg's dad and brother built it all with the help of engineers approving it. Okay, so we just flew the drone up and
these kids.
So entertained. They love it. And there's kids over here screaming, woo! So good. All right, we gotta get back now before we run out of daylight. So let's go.
Namaste, bye. Namaste. Tikta? Hajru nam keo? Nam keo?
Omar.
Omar. Miro nam Jack. Nice to meet you. Okay, bye bye. Such a cute kid. Play.
Oh, what a place to rest with a view like this.
Woo! Woo! Wow. So cool.
But just here behind me, you can see someone's cut down one of these trees for wood. Now that can be used to build a house. So they cut the timber slabs themselves, save so much money. And here is the stump where they cut it off, as you can see here. And then they saw it down into thick pieces of timber. Oh, there was a spider in front of my camera. They saw it down to thick pieces of timber. It gets used for wood. Now, some people treat the wood, others don't, because that costs money. But yeah, very interesting, isn't it? They just come to the forest and just grab whatever tree they need.
So Meg, what's one thing you love most about your village?
The environment and the water are so fresh. And another thing is, there is so many old peoples. They are also born in here, and they're still healthy. And look, I was born here, but I raised in city. I'm little bit weak in medical. So the thing is, the people are so innocent here, and the people are so lovely, and yeah, I love my village.
Good man, that's good. The man just loves his village. This is where he's born. This is where he's came multiple times to see his family. He's a part of here, and the village will always be a part of Meg as well. So good. Everything here is so picturesque. I could film everything, and that's my problem. I am filming. So when I go to edit this, there's gonna be so much footage because everything is so beautiful and I just have so much to say. So I think these episodes won't be 20 minutes. I think they'll be more like half an hour episodes because yeah, I'm just filming because everything here is just so much content. And it's so beautiful, and I want to show you guys as well. Okay, so we've now made it to Meg's house. It's gotten pretty late. The day's got on us. It's getting a little bit dark now. We've got Meg's grandma's pig just here, and the other pig. They're eating at the moment. They're getting fatter and fatter.
Fatter. Stop.
So yeah, I think I'll end the video there. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope that you're loving these videos so far and getting a really good insight into the village. The next video, I'll be explaining some stories that I've learnt from the village. Some really interesting things. It'll be sort of a different vlog, but I think it'll be worth watching. So yeah, Thank you guys so much for watching. And as always, guys, keep it real. Cheers.